So, hi, I'm Martin. I'm in the Arena Centre on the top floor at Torrington Place, the UCL building. And I'm very pleased and delighted to welcome Navi and Kaz, who are joining me because we got chatting last week after the brilliantly organised and hosted event, a panel event, where you pulled together academics and entrepreneurs to discuss generative AI, particularly in the form of chatGPT. And I thought it'd be really useful to give you the opportunity, because you don't want to always hear from us in this debate, to talk about some of your understandings and use of these technologies. So if I could start with you, Kaz.
Yes.
I'd be really interested to hear what you understand generative AI to be. What is it?
So I believe generative AI is a type of large language model which is trained based on like huge data input and is used to produce outputs such as text or images, which is like human-like outputs, I'd say. Yep.
Brilliant. Okay, so in terms of text, we're talking tools like ChatGPT.
Yeah.
And in terms of images, we're talking things like Stable Diffusion. Yep. And Midjourney and DALL-E and those kinds of things. Okay, that's great. So, Navi, what sort of things are you aware that generative AI can do?
So far, I'm aware that generative AI can it can help plan your essays. It can help you gain a deeper perspective on issues by giving, you know, the different opinions, and it can generate an output, but that output is based on probability rather than it being an actual response. So with that in mind, I've kind of been using mostly ChatGPT for some of my assignments, mainly to just give me sort of like a main idea, like a few essay points that I can further build upon. And also, I have tried to ask for sources and things like that, but I have found that it's not very useful because it kind of just makes up sources. Yeah.
So what pulled you into it then? What interested you? Why is it different to Google, say?
So I think I have been using it just because of the hype. I've heard so much about it. There's so much buzz around ChatGPT and generative AI, but I don't use it more than Google, I would say, because I find it to be more time consuming and just trying to find out the right prompts, it just takes too much time. Yeah.
That's interesting. Have you used it yourself, Kaz?
Yes, I also use it to, sometimes when I write essays, I use it to check grammars. And also, one thing I've tried is that I've inserted the essay rubrics and the essay question to the essay prompt and then told the Google Bar to assess my essay and give me some feedback to improve on like each rubric aspects. And yeah, I often use it. And in my case, I actually use the generative AIs more than Google, just because like in Google, sometimes you ask questions, but then it all refers to like some website which doesn't directly answer what I'm asking. But for generative AIs, like sometimes it might be erroneous, but it answers my questions directly. Like, it tells me what I want. So even, like, in most cases, I think they give me, like, a pretty much decent answers, I say. So, yeah.
Okay, so it's really interesting. So very in use as well. What about the wider student community? I mean, you're presumably more hooked in than I could ever possibly be. How much are students using it? And would you say that they're using it legitimately?
I mean, many of my peers are using like ChatGPT and these AIs to first come up with some essay plan. So it's not, so they just ask the question and like ask the AIs like what are some potential like topics I can explore for this essay question. So yeah, I think for like that is like the main usage by my peers, which I believe is more legitimate. But I also hear some people using it to paraphrase some research paper and put it directly to their essays, which can be problematic, especially in terms of like academic integrity, whether it can be considered cheating or not. Yeah.
So I'm going to put you on the spot now, Navi. That scenario that Kaz just described there, using it to summarize an academic paper and then taking that summary and putting it into your essay, is that a breach of academic integrity? Is that cheating, or do you think it's legitimate, new way of working?
I would say that it is a breach of academic integrity, just because, I mean, at the moment, there are certain standards for your essays, and I just want to compare it to what that standard is. Of course, in the future, that standard can change, but considering that everybody is at, you know, one playing field, some people can have an unfair advantage, which is why I think, linking back to the panel that we had last week, it's very important to develop your skills in generative AI, you know, develop that literacy so that you can use it better. So if across the board, everybody's using it in the same way, then it can be a more equal playing field.
Yeah. Excellent. Thank you very much. Okay, so a final question then, and you've kind of hinted at this already. I'll start with you, Navi. What advice would you give to students, you know, based on the panel event that you hosted and your own experiences, new students coming into HE, maybe starting in September? What advice would you give them in terms of how they could or should use generative AI?
So I think that, you know, it's very important to realize that ChatGPT isn't a replacement for your essays and what you can produce, because it simply can just point you in the right direction. And I think using that to its best capacity is the best way around it. And again, developing those skills, like for example, Kaz and I have very different experiences with generative AI, probably because he knows how to use it better and I don't. So for that, in that case, I think it is a useful skill to develop, especially now that more and more people are using it.
Yeah. Great, thanks. And Kaz, any nuggets of advice for future students?
Yeah, I agree with Navi's point. Like, as mentioned in the panel we had, AI literacy is really important. So we all, like students, we all have to know what they can do and what they can't, because sometimes they give like false information. And so, yes, in the panel, the panelists like discussed how it should be used in to like to supporting students rather than like creating the contents. That should be the main focus, AI literacy. They have to know what they're using and know what the AI can and what they cannot.
Brilliant way to finish. Thank you both so much. Thank you. Really appreciate it.